Hi, this is another video for Conscious Mosaic, and I am really lucky today to have Alex McVey with me. Alex is the incredibly talented author of Another Haint in the Holler, which is a collection of poems, and hopefully at some point we'll have him back on to discuss these poems. What other writing projects have you got going on right now, Alex?
Yeah, I've got a forthcoming chapbook of Terror and Thunder and a forthcoming novel, Three Ravens Proud.
Yeah, and I've actually had a chance to hear a little bit of Three Ravens Proud, and it's an amazing historical novel with LGBT plus characters and a sci-fi twist, which is just the kind of book that I like to read. It's a really amazing book, so and hopefully we'll can have you back on to discuss that at some point as well. Today we are here to discuss a series of novels called The Fallen. This is by Thomas E. Sniegoski. So the first thing I wanted to ask you in regard to The Fallen is, do you have any comments about stylistic choices, voicing, and other aspects of the writing?
Oh, yeah. As far as the author's voice, I have to say that there was a gap when I read these books. I got through books 1 through 5, and then there were a few years where I couldn't get a hold of 6 and 7, so I'm not sure if it was just the age difference from when I read the first ones to when I read the last, or if the author's writing style really changed that much, but it did end up grating on me in the last two books, especially since the author was very repetitive in his use of certain words for adjectives when describing actions or the characters themselves.
So one of the things I wanted to ask you about, I know that you know a whole lot about angels and the pantheons that they're used in and the different mythological contexts that angels are used in. So I wanted to ask you, in terms of the author's research about angels and the way they're used in the narrative or any other research concerns, would you like to address any of those?
So jumping off of the author's writing style and his choice of wording and such, Sniegoski commits an error that many authors do who aren't native Hebrew speakers. Caveat, I am not either, but I am able to Google. So, with these books being written in the age of Google as well as the other ones, I find it pretty egregious that he, as well as others, can't figure out what Madeleine L'Engle, who was writing in the 60s, did. That the IM ending for words like seraphim, or the words Sniegoski uses throughout his novels, Nephilim, is plural. Nephilim referring to plural beings. And he continuously uses them to describe not only the plural groups of Nephilim, but singular males and singular females. Mm. Where, for example, the singular for the male would be Nephil. As far as the rankings go, he name drops several of the archangels in his books, particularly Uriel and Gabriel. Uriel, in the first novel in particular, is serving as Soldier A under an angel called Verkiel, who is the squadron commander, which that would particularly be reversed. Gabriel is one of the characters that is somewhat featured in book 2, Leviathan, and Gabriel, for most of that novel, is just a voice in the main character Aaron's head. When Aaron does meet him in the flesh, Gabriel is immediately killed because he has been tortured for at least several years, and now is so weak that he just pretty much dies. He was being held captive and tortured by the titular Leviathan, who, despite etymologically being a whale as well as artistically being traditionally depicted as a whale, is instead in this book a Cthulhu-esque tentacle monster living in a cave. Strange, but I guess you can chalk that up to artistic liberty. Otherwise, Neither of the other two archangels, Michael or Raphael, are mentioned. The Metatron does make an appearance, however. Not played by Alan Rickman,
too
sadly,
bad.
but does have a delightful British accent and gets to be an infant for most of the sixth and seventh books. As for Verkiel, the angel I mentioned earlier, he does get a redemption arc going from genocidal maniac to asshole with a heart of gold in the last novel. He does retain his status as general, except that he goes from leading a band of angels to leading a band of goblins, a la D&D, I guess.
So, I know that you had mentioned that this is not just a series of novels, but it's also been adapted as a miniseries. Do you have any thoughts on the differences between the books and miniseries?
Yeah, ABC Family did an interpretation of the book novels as a miniseries in the early 2000s, and they seem to have crammed them all together just a bit, as you do for a miniseries. I do like the casting that they did. They really changed up the angels in particular, and I just chef kiss to that, because the author unfortunately just depicts the angels pretty much as white men, especially in the cases of Verkiel and Camille, who I distinctly remember as being described as albinos. For the miniseries, though, Camille is portrayed by an African-American man. Michael, the Archangel, makes an appearance as an Asian-American. Verkiel is changed to a woman. And to their credit, they do get a Latina actress to play Vilma, the main character, Aaron's girlfriend. I'm not sure if she was Brazilian as the character was, but she did speak Portuguese from what I remember of the miniseries, so perhaps. As for other changes and characterizations and how they're portrayed, Verkiel lasts for the whole of the first episode and is then killed, unfortunately. So that takes out that whole redemption arc that happens throughout the series. One of the Band of the Nephilim that appears as a love triangle member and foil to Aaron. Unfortunately, Aaron does not have to choose between this character and Vilma, but Jeremy Fox is replaced by the fallen angel Azazel, who is pretty much the British David Bowie bisexual wears leopard print does crimes guy. And the most egregious example of the casting, I have to say, is Aaron's father, Lucifer, who, instead of being a 40 to 45-something-year-old guy who has family issues with his son and needs to make up with him and his wife, girlfriend, what have you, baby mama, is instead played in the show by a 40 to or 50 to 60 year old Regis Philbin looking gentleman who is very Darth Vader-y. It's more of a come to the dark side, we have cookies, instead of where instead of where in the novel Lucifer and Satan are two different individuals, Lucifer being Aaron's father and obviously having angst about the whole Heavenly War thing, since God decided to put all of these spirits of his fallen comrades, both on his side and on the heavenly side, inside of him, and thus created hell. And Satan in the novel being a primordial being from the time when darkness was and God had not spoken light into the world yet, well, into the universe yet. And in the miniseries, they just recombined Lucifer and Satan, as you do for most portrayals.
So this has been an interview with Alex McVey on The Fallen. We are really happy to have him here and hope to have him back in the future. If you are interested in pitching an idea for a video or doing an interview or anything here on Conscious Mosaic, please contact me at ing@ingvenning.com, and I will leave the email and my website below, as well as Alex's website, so you can check out his work. Please like, comment, share, subscribe, and help grow this channel as a place where people can talk about art and share their work and the work of others, because we'd like to grow this little channel. And thank you so much for being here. Have a fantastic day.
See you guys next time.